In this video, I'm going to play a clip from a discussion that Sheikh Uthman bin Farooq had with an Arabic-speaking Christian. In the discussion, he tries to expose this Christian's knowledge of Arabic to undermine his criticisms and arguments against Islam. I'll let the whole clip play out, then dissect it, and we'll see together who actually exposed their knowledge of Arabic.
I just have one little question for Qais, real quick. I'm going to jump off. I'll let you guys have fun. But Qais, you're Arab, right?
Yeah, I'm Arab, yes.
What does innama mean?
Sorry?
The first hadith that we just mentioned in Bukhari, the first word innama, what does innama mean?
Give it to me in a sentence.
Innama al-amalu bin-niyat.
Yeah, that means... Why are you laughing, brother? Why?
Because you don't know.
Why are you judging so quick?
Innama, I'm listening.
Means, wait. Don't judge too quick, brother. Innama I'm listening. Means, but it means innama, but it depends on the context. The word innama means but. So I can say no. Just
innama means but.
So I can say. هذا يذهب إلى البيت أو هذا الرجل يذهب إلى البيت. Wait. إنما تلك المرأة تذهب إلى السوق. So yeah, you can love as much as you want.
Please.
You can love as much as
you want. You know what Snoop Al-Husser is?
Brother, I just wanted to say to Brother Hashim,
hold on, Qais, you're jumping.
You asked me about Peter.
Lakin could be used for but. إنما Snoop Al-Husser, it's Tawkeed. You don't know. Look, the point I'm making to you, Qais, you're coming on here, you don't understand the hadith, you don't understand what's sahih, you don't even know Arabic properly because you don't know what innama is. Anybody who speaks Arabic that's watched this knows you used it incorrectly. Innama is not used for but. Innama is used for tawkeed, slob al-husr. Understand?
No, you're mistaken.
Go home, pick up your Nahu books. I'm out. Assalamu alaikum to the Muslims.
All right, let's get into it. First, he asks,
what does innama mean?
According to the dictionary, innama means but, however, indeed, rather, truly, verily, yet. Which meaning it has in a sentence depends on the context, but when you ask what it means, any of those definitions are correct, as long as you caveat that the meaning could change depending on the context it's used in. If somebody asks you what the definition of hard was, and you told them that hard means something that's difficult, you'd be correct, although it has other meanings in other contexts. For example, the test was extremely hard, meaning the test was extremely difficult. Now you can use it in another context, and in that context it could have another meaning. For example, the rock is hard, meaning that the rock has mass to it, that the rock is solid. Both definitions are correct. It just depends on which context you're using the word in.
Innama I'm listening.
Means, wait. Don't judge too quick, brother. Innama I'm listening. Means, but it means innama, but it depends on the context. The
word. We see that he defines the word innama as but, just like this dictionary says. And he's correct. That is what innama means. And then he also says that it depends on the context. So it's very curious as to why the sheikh is laughing. He can't contain himself from laughing. Why? Is it because he knows Arabic or he doesn't know Arabic? Who's really exposing their knowledge of Arabic here?
So I can say... no.
Innama means but?
Innama means but? Yes, Sheikh, it does mean but. That's exactly how the dictionaries define the word and that's how it's used in Arabic. Why are you laughing? Why do you find this so funny? Do you actually know Arabic or do you not know Arabic?
So I can say... no.
Innama means but?
So just to recap, the Sheikh is using one Arabic word to determine this guy's knowledge of Arabic and how well he speaks and knows Arabic in order to correctly criticize or argue against Islam. We've seen so far that he's been failing so hard, so bad, that he doesn't even know Arabic himself. And right now he's about to expose it big time.
Qais, you're jumping.
You asked me about Lakin
could be used for but. Innama slob al-husr, it's tawkeed. You don't know. Innama is not used for but.
Responding to the last part first, he actually says innama does not mean but. However, every Arabic dictionary defines the word innama as but. Depending on its context, it can mean other things, but depending on its context, it does mean but. Furthermore, he gives us the Arabic word that means but.
لكن...
Now, this is where it gets really funny, because when you look at the Arabic dictionary, the Arabic dictionaries, meaning the dictionaries that are written in Arabic explaining what Arabic words mean in the Arabic language, we see that they define the word innama in one of its definitions as lakin, the very word he's saying means but, as opposed to innama. In fact, Sheikh, innama means lakin, depending on the context. You just expose to everybody your lack of knowledge of Arabic. Now, this part here is really added as a bonus. Listen to what he says.
As much as you want.
Please. You know what Slob al-Husr is?
There's no such thing as Slob al-Husr in Arabic. It's Aslub. Aslub, not Slob. So it's really funny that he's trying to expose this guy's knowledge of Arabic when he himself clearly doesn't have a strong grasp of Arabic. In fact, what he says next perfectly fits him.
You don't even know Arabic properly. Thank you.